first time I came up here, I went over and talked to Roberta Gregor this afternoon, Mike, and I did when I got here. I remember back way when I was a real young guy, Odell Martin and I came up here and picked. Couldn't get Bose to play. And I never would forget. Finally begged him about an hour and he finally played him. Bose was the kind of guy, no matter how bad you played, but he'd always brag on you and tell you the best he ever heard. Said, well, I always like to play like that. I never would forget that. I'm gonna play one more tune, unless somebody else. Play a little bit. I'm gonna do this for Tom Brett. By the way, this is not a plug, but I did a video about a month ago. It's our video, will be out in June, and it's gonna be a volume one, volume two. I did 18 tunes, we're gonna make two videos out of it. And also gonna be a CD on it. All that modern stuff. So it comes out as an enticement to get people to buy it. We're going to give out a 100-pound bag of Purina dog chow. It's tough to sell things nowadays, friend. I want to dedicate this to Tom Brady. He's been trying to learn this. I've been trying to show it to him for years. If I live long enough, I think that you'll get it. He's almost got it. Tom Brady's one of the best guitar players I know, and he gets a great sound while other Tom's playing. He must be in his jeans, you reckon? I'm hoping someday they'll name an alley for me. They got all these streets and everything named after people, and so they may have an alley back here somewhere. It'll be the Paul Yannadel Alley. Thank you.
just for burps.
Well, I ain't used to doing this, as you'll find out. I don't know hardly what to pick, but I'll grab one here that I used to hear. Moe's grown, a lot of people pick.
Thank you.
list here, but it's done everything I know. Why not play this?
Smoke yourself today. You'll say, Peter, up Golden Gate, that you paid the man. well, I've heard of that son of a gun in the first grade. And I ain't that I don't smoke myself, and I don't bring it in handy your health. See, I've been smoking all my life, and I ain't dead yet. Yeah. Nicotine slaves are all the same. At a pet and part of your poker game, everything's got to stop while you have that cigarette. Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, 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 and if you smoke yourself to death, till St. Peter of the Golden Gate, you hate making weight. You just got to have another cigarette. Well, I gave a chance the other night. The old Dame Fortune was doing me right. Cards kept on coming around. I played them hard, and I bet them high. My bluff wouldn't work, and a certain guy just kept on betting and laying that damn money down. Sweated blood, had to sink or swim. Finally he raised and called, didn't raise the bet. I'll get this right in a minute or two. Yeah. Finally he called, didn't raise the bet. I said, hey, small pal, how about you? And he said, I'll tell you in a minute or two, but right now I gotta have this damn cigarette. It's right in my mind. Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, puff, puff. And if you smoke yourself to death, well, just ain't Peter of the Golden Gate. You hate to make him wait. You just got to have another cigarette. Well, the other night I had a date with the prettiest gal in these 50 states, real high-bred uptown, fancy little girl. She said she loved me, and it seemed to me that everything's about like it ought to be, so hand in hand, we strolled down Congress Avenue. She was also far from the date of ice, and our smooching party was going right now, so John Hartford wouldn't have showed up, I'd have been there yet. She gave me a kiss, a little squeeze, she said, Brush, excuse me, but I got to have myself a pal mail. Smoke, smoke, smoke that cigarette. Puff, 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 and if you smoke yourself to death, tell St. Peter of the Golden Gate, you hate to make him wait, you just got to have another cigarette. Too many words coming at you all at the same time. That's one of those you got to keep doing all the time. You forget the words. We were talking about a man outside, one of the most brilliant guitarists and songwriters and people ever to come around in our lifetime. Paul and I were out there, he was mentioning it, a man by the name of Jerry Reed. Jerry was an influence on a lot of guitar players today. I mean, it's hard to do anything without sneaking a Reed lick in there. And I wrote a song about Jerry because I've just loved him all these years. He was such an influence. And I'm going to do this song for you. It's called Reed Between the Strings, and it goes like this. It was 1960 something when I first became a fan. When he took his breath, there was no mistake, it was Reed between the strings. Where are you going, sir? I'm getting a different pick. the sails back at night. It was shining on that old Kentucky home. Well, I had learned one day he loved to play that old guitar that his brother Taylor made. He scrimped and he saved every dime that he made. Then he went downtown with one thing on his mind: to buy that guitar in the window with a body polished new, with silver strings that shine like the early morning dew. He gave up his last dollar just so he could play the blues. He loved it so, the guitar in the window. Well, that guitar knew everything you do. Joy and pain, it would always see him through. He'd sing and it would play in that old familiar way. He gave 16 tons of pleasure in his life. Then the phone call came with the morning, and the way I felt, I don't need to say. The news came fast without warning. The man from Kentucky passed away. But the Hall of Fame is giving his old friend a brand new home. But it's all along the guitar in the window. How he loved that guitar in the window. Thanks for having me out here. Moe's Rager, we love you out there.
Thank you. She put it on the table with his legs poking up in the rain.
Thank you.
and the blowing wives and the junkyards and the highways come between us. And some other woman cried to her mother cause she turned and I was gone. I steal my money in silence, tears of joy might stain my face, and a summer sun might burn me till I'm warm.
Thank you. like to play you a little tune I wrote. About a little man that does a little dance. Shucking Sam.
I
blues singing back there. So, I hope you enjoy a few numbers we do here.
Thank you. Pets are impressive. He's called Stardust.
Thank you. try to sing a song that I haven't sang too many times since I was here last. Song about the area, phone lines. Everybody knows what it is. Return.
Look.
all around, cause he's got rhythm in his bones. He beats on skill, shuffle and drag. Every time they hit the rhythm, he's all right. He is a honky tonk. He is a grown man grown. He's a big hand and a fucking strength. Now he can do it, he can do the fucking wings. All the fat in his feet does a little shimmy and the head start wiggling whack. Yeah, the feet start scooting with a shovel and drag. Every time they hit the rhythm, he's all right. Does a little shimmy and the head starts to wiggle and whack. Yeah, the beat starts scooting with the shovel and drag. Every time they hit the rhythm, it gets all right. Yeah, the beat starts scooting with the shovel and drag. Every time they hit the rhythm, it gets all right. Thank you.
I know your song, man. I don't guess it really needs any introduction.
Now, what we're doing, we have a lot of performances tonight, so we're making sure we get all the chords and everything out of the way. So when I go over to visit the audience, I don't fall flat on my face like I almost have. Are we set?
We've done that
before. Does that mean okay, John? All right. This is a performance of Sidewalks of Bordeaux. Mm-hmm. Here's our friend Tom Brash on Music City tonight. My, I hope you were around before the break to hear this man picking on this guitar, this very unusual guitar of Tom Brash. Your name's all over the guitar, but I mean...
Well, what's... I want to make sure you remembered who I was.
Well, Charlie,
I will remember. No problem. We'll remember, but what's the story with this guitar here?
This guitar was built for me by a man that's been building all my guitars for 15 years. He's in Holland, Michigan. His name's Del Langyans. And when I was in France a couple of years ago, there was a guitar maker over there that had a guitar with a steel string guitar on one side and a nylon string guitar on the other side. But it was the way he showed. He says, I make this guitar, this is the way I make my steel string guitar. Then he turned it around, but it wasn't real playable.
Right.
So I called Dell and I said, you think you could build this thing? And I sent a picture to him and all that. And he said, yeah, I think I could. And then Lloyd Baggs, who makes great pickups, Baggs made the pickups for it.
Because
it took special pickups, you know, it took, there's two pickups, one on each side. See, this is a steel string here. It's like, it's got that sound.
Right.
Then when you flip it over, you have the classical nylon string guitar that's got the more, or that funky Jerry Reed. Stomping stuff. But so that's what it's all about. And I told Dell, I said, make me something that I can just flip her on over and play it. So he did, and it works great.
Oh, very handy.
It's too cool.
You know? Is this the only guitar like this that exists in the world that you know of?
Well, you could have one if you wanted to dish up about, I think he's going to go about $7,000.
$7,000,
yeah.
Huh? Oh, man.
And I don't know if that's with or without your name on it.
Surely they toss that in for nothing. But, you know, the question is, I guess a lot of guitar pickers are wondering this. If you're playing one side, the other side's kind of rubbing against your body there a little bit. Doesn't that get it out of tune or mess up the strings or anything?
No. And actually, the theory that I think on this guitar is two-neck steel string guitar, I find one neck starts to take off when you're playing the steel string, the nylon string starts resonating. So that's why I thought it would be
good. I hate
good.
It when they do that, you know?
See? I mean, you can't hear anything. It's just, it's against your body. And so far, knock on this very expensive wood, it hasn't gone out of tune.
Cool.
Well,
all
you
right.
are such a talented guitarist. Are there
Thank
times
you.
When you amaze yourself at what you can do with a guitar?
Yeah, I'm always amazing myself. If I can play it, I'm amazed. You know?
Well, there are a couple of CDs out.
These amaze me, too, these two.
Well, no. Son of a Guitar-Picking Man and Saturday Night Shuffle, the celebration of Merle Travis, which, by the way, Merle Travis is your father.
Yeah.
And I'm curious, since Merle was such a great picker, and here you are such a great picker, how much of it do you think, and I mean this in a serious manner, how much of it is inherited, do you think?
Travis always got a kick out of that because he really, in my youth, never showed me anything. I've always been able to do that thumb style guitar. See, the whole style is built around your thumb playing the bass and the rhythm. Then your fingers aren't doing anything, so they play the melody. Like so. And Travis never showed me a thing when I was a kid, and he always got a kick out of it. He'd tell people, Travis talked like this, you know. He'd say, well, it's just in the genes. It's just in the genes. And so I've always been able to play that style, that thumb style.
So maybe
course,
some do that.
Of course, I've been so influenced by Chet Atkins as so many guitar players. I mean, Chet is just the technical guitar player of all time. He's just, you know, he's Chet Atkins. That's why he's Chet Atkins.
Right.
And Jerry Reed was also a very big influence on me. Hey, I've got a picking instructional video coming out March 1st called The Real Travis Guitar. It's on Homespun Tapes. They make all these instructional things.
Yeah.
And I'm playing Travis's actual old super, or his old Martin D28 guitar with the original Bigsby neck.
Well,
and
now,
it's
wait a
good
minute.
If you want to learn to play just like me.
Okay, now that's what I was going to ask. Is this video for people like me?
No, actually it's not.
It's not.
It's you have to be,
I mean, I can't
of all,
play a thing.
No, you have to be a guitar player for this video because trying to teach the style from the beginning is kind of crazy. But so many people are interested in a lot of the songs that Travis played in the style once they are guitar players and can get it out. So.
Well, the thing about this particular guitar you have, this is designed specifically for you because you are a professional, you're very versatile with the guitar, and you're able to flip it over and do all these different styles. So that someday may be a collector's item as well right there.
You never know, this might wind up in the Country Music Hall of Fame.
Hall of Fame, not Hall of Shame.
Oh, yours is in the back room, right?
Hey,
yeah, okay.
Speaking of shame, you are shameless when it comes to some of these impressions. Are you going to do some of the your impersonations for us a little later?
Well, I thought maybe I'd do a little Chet Atkins for you a little bit later. Chet says I don't sound a bit like
you
it.
You do. We sound like him a lot.
I do. No.
Well, now, wait a minute. We mentioned these CDs a minute ago. Do we have time to tell him how to get these particular CDs? Boy, you want to hear some great guitar picking?
We have an address.
You can write to his fan club. The fan club address is P.O. Box 24775. That 7 is right in the middle of the flowers. I think that's a 7.
Yes, 24.
Nashville, 37202. And it's $15 for the CDs, $10 for the cassettes. They'll give you all the information there.
Okay, hang in there. for some impersonations from Tom Brish.
You're going to make me do those, aren't you?
We're going to make you do them a little later on. First, though, this was a hit that was had by...
Money order or use your credit card.
Tonight has returned. Now, we had Tom Brush over here with this four-sided guitar he was playing and all that.
It's just a two-sided
He's
guitar.
A great picker, but he also has a weird streak in him, a comedic
Yeah, side. A weird sense of humor, and he can do impressions of some kind of, well, the people themselves aren't bizarre, but his impressions are. Once again, Tom Brush.
We were talking earlier, about what song I wish I would have recorded if I could have recorded any song. And of course, I came up with Achy Breaky Heart. I figured that is the song. If you're gonna record one, that's the one to do. I figured anybody can do that song. You people at home, you can do it. Waylon Jennings would do it great. He could make a comeback. Check this out, if Waymore did it. Well, you can tell your pa that I moved to Arkansas. You can tell your dog about my leg. Tell your brother Cliff, this can tell my lips, that I never really liked you anyway. Take her, Willie. Tell your Aunt Louise, tell anyone you please. I can tell myself I'm not okay. You can tell my eye to watch out for my mind, cause he might be walking out on me today. No, no, let's see. Wait, I got a good one for you. Maybe I didn't pay my taxes quite as often as I should. Have fun doing Willie. I have more fun if I was doing Laurie Morgan or somebody like that. I just can't sing high enough. I got one for you. John Conley. John Conley, you'll love this. He could have done this song really good. He might have done it as a ballad.
Well, baby, don't break my heart. Not my achy, breaky heart. Cause I just don't think he'd understand. See that, John?
For Ross Perot. He's looking for something to do. Might as well come here to Nashville and let Jimmy Bowen give him a record deal. If Ross Perot did it,
now I'm gonna tell you. Now here's the deal. And if you break my heart, my achy breaky heart. Now you with me on this thing? You're gonna hear a giant sucking sound from down there in Mexico like you never heard before.
Let's see, who else we got? Who else we got?
How about a little bit of Fred G. Sanford? Big, ugly Fred. Put his face in some dough and make gorilla cookies, big, ugly Fred. Now listen, dummy, don't break my heart. Not my big, ugly, achy, breaky heart. Because you see, listen, it's beautiful, isn't it? I just don't think that you'll understand.
Or Arnold Schwarzenegger would do it good. He's got muscles, you know. And if you break my heart, my achy breaky heart, he might blow up and terminate me. I'm not sure. Let's see, I got more. As Bobby Helms says, isn't this pitiful? Yes, pitiful. Let's see. Oh, here's a good one for you. The Sons of the Pioneers. They could make a comeback with this. Don't break my heart, my achy breaky heart. Whoopie tie, yi, yippee, yippee, yay. Now, Bob Dylan, check this out.
Yeah.
Achy, achy, biggy heart. I got a big, big heart. Yes, indeed, I do. I got one more for you. This guy would have killed it. He's on a roll. He doesn't need this. But check this song, how it works for John Anderson. Well, don't break my heart, my achy, breaky heart. I just don't think he'd understand. Break my heart, my achy, breaky heart. He mightn't blow up and kill this man. You're a good bunch, thank you.
Bob Dylan there,
hey,
huh?
Tom, let me ask you this off camera just a minute. I mean, how long do you sit at home at night and make these things up?
Oh, hey, I don't even
see it. Yeah, it goes into Rodney Dangerfield.
Oh, that's funny.
I was looking at next week's lineup. There is a possibility that we might be...